15, so we should be getting into bed soon. I got you a little glass of warm milk. I've been drinking like warm milk before bed recently. It's quite calming. Nice, isn't it? I like it. Alrighty. Well, I brought some items with me, and I'm just gonna help you sleep tonight. We're gonna do some skincare, some little massages, some nice face brushing. I got this recently, which I thought would be really nice to use. It's a thing called a sinus pillow. And it's got like lavender in it, which smells really nice. You can make it cold or hot. And it helps relieve like tension and headaches, and kind of just helps like any strained muscle. So now we can use this for sure. But let's do your skincare first. Start off with your skincare, okay? We're just gonna do some toner. Just get rid of all that dirt and oil. There you go. I'm gonna take this Q-tip just to clean underneath your eyes. Sometimes I like to just straighten out my brows. Put on some eye cream for you. You want to protect those eye bags, okay? Gonna put on a little sleeping mask just to protect your skin during the night. Keep it nice and hydrated. Good. For the last part of the skincare, I'm just gonna protect your lips for the night, just so that they can stay nice and hydrated and moisturized. Dip a little bit on. Put a little bit on too. Now, just relax all your body, you know, cleanse your jaw, unfurl your brows. Just let yourself relax, okay? To help, I'm gonna spray this goodnight spray. I really love the smell of this. I use the oil in an oil diffuser for a long time, and then I saw they had a spray, which is even better. So I'm gonna spray this just on your pillow. It has lavender and tangerine, bergamot, cypress, geranium, coconut, and frankincense and chamomile oil. It just smells lovely. It smells very refreshing and calming. And I think it'll really help aid you into sleeping tonight, okay? So now that we got that, I think now is a good time before this runs cold. Going along with the lavender scents, if you just wear this for a little bit, just on your eyes, just to help relax your eyes and any tension, you know, especially if you've been looking at a screen for a long time today. So I'll put that on, and you can just stay with your eyes closed for a little bit. Take some deep breaths. Relax and feel all the muscles going up your legs, untensing to your hips, your tummy, your chest, your shoulders. Drop your shoulders. Make sure your arms are relaxed, your hands aren't clenched, your jaw isn't clenched. Nice and relaxed, okay? Just let yourself slowly sink into the bed more. Let yourself feel heavy. And let yourself feel fully at peace. I'll take this off. I hope that felt nice. You're getting a little sleepy, I can tell. Now it's a good time for you to have a nice little cuddle buddy for the night. She's very nice, I promise. I'll put her right here next to you, so you can just hug her and feel nice and safe. I want to use some lotion now, just to massage your hands for a little bit. brush in for you. Pretty soon, I'll end with some reading, so you can just doze off to my voice and get a good night's rest, okay? We start reading. I have my Kindle here. I've been reading a book recently called I Hear You. It is a book about like communication with just anyone, just making or helping others when you talk to them feel, you know, validated and heard, and just better communication skills. So I'm gonna read this tonight. I am about 21% into the book. Reading part that was like an example, so I'll skip that part and we'll get on to another example. So the first example was about you know, what is good validation and what is not the best way to validate someone when they're coming to you. So the second example is about feeling insecure. It says, let's say you're talking to a friend who has been feeling insecure about her looks. After a particularly hard day, she plops down on your couch and sighs. I'm never gonna get a guy to date me. Most people's knee-jerk reaction would be to shoot the comment down, insist it's not true, and proceed to build her friend up with plenty of praise and encouragement. Would you have done the same? Even if that was your initial impulse, you've probably read enough of this book by now to suspect there's always a better approach. Say you do shoot back with something like, that's not true, you're totally going to find someone. That wouldn't be a bad response. You might be afraid if you don't say something like that, she'll think you do, think she's lost cause. But let's be real here for a second. If you immediately respond with, that's not true, will it really make her feel any better? Will she have a stroke of insight and say, oh, okay, thank you, and then go on her merry way? Not likely. A response like that might take the edge off for a second or two, but it's not going to have any sort of lasting effect. Even if you, her coworkers, her family, and every person she talks to insist that she's beautiful, fun, smart, etc., it doesn't change the fact that she feels unattractive in some way. There are countless... I'm even feeling sleepy. Whenever you're ready to sleep, just go ahead and close your eyes and drift off, okay? You don't have to pay too much attention to what I'm reading or focus on my words. Just let my voice help you sleep, okay? There are countless accounts of professional models. We're talking people who literally get paid because everyone thinks you're gorgeous, admitting to feeling ugly and unlovable. In cases like these, there's something deeper going on, a reason why the person is being the way they are. And if we're being real here, the only way for your friend to truly feel lovable is to work through those issues and feelings. Here is where validation becomes so valuable. As we discussed earlier, it's very difficult for someone to work through difficult issues when they're blinded by strong emotions. Painful or difficult emotions get stronger and more intimidating when fought or suppressed. When you validate other people, you help them see and accept their emotions for what they are, just feelings, neither good nor bad. This makes it significantly easier for them to process them and break free. So how do you validate in a situation like this? If you aren't going to just shoot your friend's comment down and try to build her up, what do you do? Get curious about the situation. Ask questions to understand the emotion she's feeling and where it's coming from. She could be feeling hurt, embarrassed, sad, angry, or any other mixture of emotions. We'll walk through a few tips, and techniques for uncovering someone's feelings later in the book. But a more validating response might look like the following. I'm never going to get a guy to date me. What? Why do you say that? I just see all these beautiful women everywhere and I'm nowhere near as pretty. There are a lot of beautiful women here. It's hard not to compare yourself to others. Yeah, it sucks. Why do you feel like you're not as beautiful? Jay said something the other night that really got to me. You can see from this example how validation paired with little curiosity can start to uncover the root causes of someone's feelings. In this instance, a mixture of curiosity and empathy led to some insight about why your friend is feeling insecure. This additional insight will enable you to offer deeper validation in the areas that will have the most impact. And put you in a better position feedback, advice, and assurance. Validating versus invalidating responses. Before we wrap this chapter up, let's round out our understanding by taking a quick look at some side-by-side comparisons of validating versus invalidating responses. Each example consists of one comment and two possible responses, one validating and one invalidating. These are short, sweet, and to the point, but if you're looking for a little extra credit, take a moment or two to think up a few additional validating responses for each situation. Comment: I'm worried about this upcoming exam. Invalidating response would be, don't be, you'll do great, I'm sure of it. Validating response: I don't blame you, this is a hard class. Comment: the cold is so annoying. I can't sleep. I have a hard time breathing. My throat is killing me. Invalidating response: that's unfortunate, but you'll get over it. It could be worse. My neighbor got the flu last year and was bedridden for almost a month. Validating response: ah, that sounds miserable. It's so frustrating not being able to sleep when you're sick, and I can't stand sore throats. I don't want to go to school anymore. I'm so embarrassed after last night's talent show that I don't ever want to show my face there again. Invalidating response: you have nothing to be embarrassed about. You did a great job. Validating response: I'm sorry, honey. It's tough getting up there in front of the whole school like that, especially when you're performing. Is there anything specific you're worried about? Congratulations, you just completed Validation 101. You now have a solid understanding of the basics and are ready for a more thorough and actionable deep dive. Chapters 3 and 4 will clear up common misconceptions, citing interesting research and personal experience, giving you a crash course on empathy to set you up nicely for the powerful principles in Part 2. Validation has two main elements. It 1. Acknowledges a specific emotion, and 2. Offers justification for feeling that emotion. Validation is non-judgmental. It allows the other person to feel whatever they're feeling without labeling it as good or bad. Invalidation is a counterproductive. Research has shown that invalidating responses can make a situation worse, even when offered with the best of intentions. Offering validation before or instead of offering advice or concerns is often the best way to help. Doing so helps others let go of difficult emotions much more quickly, often allowing them to find a solution to the problem on their own. Leading with validation also increases the likelihood that others will listen to